You know, in this pandemic, what I tried to do was to cook something special for my children. Some of the dishes I cooked were dishes I tried in our French restaurant before, and they loved it. So it's about, like I always mention, it's about surprising the people that you're feeding with something new but yet delicious. A few months ago, I made a Pinoy carbonara. That was very, very good, but that one had cream. Now, later on, I learned how to make the authentic carbonara. This is it. Here's what we need for today's Italian carbonara. For the noodles, we need pasta spaghetti, water for boiling, and salt. Then we have guanciale or smoked pork or a slab of bacon that is cut into small cubes. We also have 3 pieces of crushed garlic, 5 beaten eggs, pecorino cheese or good Parmesan cheese, and a teaspoon of pepper. Now what I have here is boiling water. I put a little salt. I have 500 grams of good pasta noodles. Here's spaghetti noodles. Yan. And now, the noodles, they say you're supposed to boil for about 9 minutes. So at around 7 minutes, I'm going to stop and check it because I like my noodles to be al dente. Then what you have to do is get a nice slab bacon. Actually, the original carbonara is made with guanciale. Guanciale are pork cheeks na bacon, no? And then you cut it into cubes. What I'm trying to do here is just extract the fat. Now, let me start off by getting my... I have here eggs, okay? I have 5 egg yolks. And then the original recipe that uses cheese is they use pecorino cheese. But what I've done is I just use Parmesan cheese, a good Parmesan cheese, ah. Then I'm gonna put some pepper, okay? And then I'm going to just mix all of these together well with my fork, okay? In one of our dinners, a friend of mine, he made carbonara. I was going to make the carbonara, but he said, no, I'll make it. And then what he did was, with the guanciale or yung bacon, he put some garlic. So parang, I was telling myself, di masarap to. But you know what? The carbonara came out really, really good because there was a tinge of yung aroma of garlic. Sarap. Okay, so let's see what we're doing. This is dry toasting. Now, I have the pasta here. You have to just mix this every so often, otherwise they stick together. What we'll do, I have here garlic, just to add a little aroma. You don't do this in authentic carbonara, but there's a cookbook, Italian cookbook, made by this lady, and she put garlic, so you can try it. But you know, I tried it, it was so, so good. But let me come back to this one the moment we extracted the oil. I have here garlic on the bacon, okay? Just to have this garlicky flavor. And then what we will do is we will get some of this pasta water, okay? And add it to the... Yan. You remember we don't add cream to this bacon? Look at it, oh. There's a little white in the mixture of the pasta water and the bacon. And that acts like your cream. Yum. Okay? So we are just going to mix this very, very well. And now, look at it, oh. Look at that beautiful color. And then we are going to test our noodles. Let's just see the doneness. You know, like I mentioned, sometimes from the feel of your wooden spoon, you can tell the doneness. So what you want to do is test it. But be careful because this is so hot. Okay. Mmm. Okay, let me get some of this pasta water. Okay, you remember the mixture of the egg and the Parmesan cheese and the pepper? So what I'm going to do is get the pasta, okay? This will cook the mixture of the egg and the Parmesan cheese. Like I say, if you have pecorino, go ahead and do that, no, or use that. Now, if you remember, the bacon has ano, the flavor of, slight flavor of garlic, okay? And you have a choice. What I've done here is I used whole eggs. Okay, so here, we're going to put our bacon. Okay, look at me. Sayang eh. I want to get all those flavors there. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. And all you have to do is just mix it together. Mix all the flavors are at the bottom, remember? Oh, I can smell the pepper. You know, this dish, is actually very simple, but it relies, like most Italian dishes, it relies on the quality of the ingredients. So if you notice from the heat of the pasta, it was able to cook the beaten egg and Parmesan cheese. Okay, so there you have it. This one is called authentic Italian carbonara with a tinge of garlic. Another hearty and easy meal to prepare is a sandwich. So I'm going to show you how to make my version of a Caesar chicken salad sandwich. Up next at Casa Daza. Many, many decades ago, we had a French restaurant called Au Bon Vivant. At that time, that was the number one fine dining restaurant in the entire country. And I remember I was still a small boy. No, I had no idea what it was. But I remember her food was very good. I had no idea what I was eating. But now I realize that apparently the chefs that we would bring in from France were Michelin star chefs. So, you know, this is the first time I tried Chateaubriand Bernaise, a Poulet Grand Mère, what have you, know. And one of the dishes that we used to serve, table side, this is in the mid-60s, was Caesar salad. Today, what I'm going to make is a Caesar salad dressing, but I'm going to make it into a sandwich. For my version of Caesar salad chicken sandwich, you will need garlic, anchovy fillets, egg yolks, grapeseed oil or extra virgin olive oil, table mustard, lemon juice, Worcestershire sauce, and good Parmesan cheese. We also have some chopped fried crispy bacon, a head of lettuce, bread, cooked and shredded chicken, mayonnaise, and salt. I have some garlic. What I'm going to do with the garlic is I'm going to crush it. Okay? Okay, yan. And then I'm going to use the back of a wooden spoon and just crush and mash this garlic, okay? Mash. The flavors, garlic is very, very strong. And then I have about, what, 5 or 6 anchovy fillets. And what I'm going to do with this also, I'm going to mash it, no? Using the back of the spoon. You know, this requires patience. You know, you can also use a blender for this. The problem with that, you know, there's such a thing as overbeating it, no? And you don't want to do that. I tried it minsan, oh my gosh, it was overblended. But you know, there's a reward in being patient for something like this. Now, next thing you're going to do, I have all the ingredients ready here, no? Is I have some egg yolks, okay? Egg yolks. You mix all of this together, and some people say, oh, that's raw, those are raw egg yolks. No, okay, you beat the egg yolks like this, put it over hot water, just apply a little heat, just so that, you know, whatever bacteria there is, if there are any, will be cooked a little bit. So I have some boiling water. Parang what you're doing with chocolate, actually it's like making mayonnaise also. Mayonnaise is egg yolks and oil. Okay, now, the moment you've done that, okay, you get your olive oil so that you add extra virgin olive oil. Okay, you're like making mayonnaise. Okay. At this point, this has no taste, zero taste, okay? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in some table mustard. Not Dijon, just plain table mustard, okay? Then I have some lemon juice, okay? Worcestershire sauce, yan. And then, let's get this and pour this over the mixture of bacon and the anchovies, remember? Yan. Just mix all of these together very, very well. Okay. But you know what will liven this? Is if you add some Parmesan cheese, we'll awaken this. Then we'll add some bacon. Then mix that all together. Now what we will do is, let's taste this again. Okay na siya. Okay na siya. Now, what we'll do, at this point, you have a salad dressing ready, a Caesar salad dressing. Set aside, the taste of the garlic is so strong and the saltiness of the anchovies. some of this dressing, and then get some lettuce. Okay. I'll slice the lettuce a bit, no? Yes, I saw this in a restaurant somewhere in Makati and I thought it was such a brilliant idea. What kind of bread will you use? You can use mga ciabatta, you can use any kind of bread, but I suggest you don't toast it. Don't toast the bread, okay? Because I don't like the mixture of it being hot. So what I've done here is I have some bread, okay? Nice kind of just plain white bread. So I'm just putting mayonnaise, okay? And then I'm going to put some lettuce. This is what we call a chicken Caesar salad sandwich. I love this sandwich and my kids love this also. Then I have some bacon here. A little more bacon. Some of the flaked chicken. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put a little rock salt. And this is it. So there you have it. This one is called chicken Caesar salad sandwich or a Caesar salad dressing. Up next, our final dish is a hearty croque monsieur and I will show you how to make it right here at Casa Daza. Many moons ago, I lived in Paris. I was there for about 3 years, though, and I lived in an area which they called the Left Bank. A few blocks down was a street called Saint-Michel. Saint-Michel is a highly populated tourist area. And along the streets of Saint-Michel, you have a lot of shops and many restaurants. In front of the restaurants, you had this place of different kinds of food. And one of the most popular that attracted a lot of tourists were their crepes. Of course, so different kinds of crepes with Nutella, maybe bananas, what have you, no? And one of those that really caught my eye was an item called croque monsieur. And then they also had a sandwich made with the baguette and hot dog, yung crunchy hot dog with melted cheese on top. So if you order that, they throw it in the oven and heat it and give it to you. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make you a French croque monsieur. To prepare croque monsieur, you will need bread, any kind of bread, butter, flour, milk, cream, egg yolks, grated Gruyere or Emmental cheese, salt, pepper, cayenne pepper, cheese slices, sliced farmer's ham, Dijon mustard, and Parmesan cheese. So let's start. You get a good quality bread. Now, a lot of people, what they do is they like to cut the sides of the bread. I don't. I like to have it as is, no? So what I'm going to do is get bread. I have this huge kind of bread. Just brush it with butter. Okay? And the reason I want to do that is because I want to add a little firmness to this bread. Next is I'm just going to put a little firmness to this by toasting it a little bit, no? Siguro mga 5 minutes. Now, what I want to do here is you get the rack or yung grill where there is an opening at the bottom because what happens is you put the toast bread on the pan like this, the one on top will be crispy, the one at the bottom will be moist, no? I don't want that. I want both to be crispy. Now, I'm going to make a sauce. This is actually a basic bechamel sauce, no? But this one is called sauce mornay. And then we're going to put some flour, okay? Mix this together. You have to cook this flour and the butter mixture. Otherwise, it's going to taste starchy. So we'll add some milk. Some cream. Actually, you know, if you want to skip the cream, it's fine. Okay, so add the cream. Then we'll add some egg yolk. Okay, 2 egg yolks. Ito, at this point, it has no taste pa. Okay, so we're going to add some salt and pepper. Season that with salt and pepper. A little pepper. And then, yung cayenne, okay? And mix all of these together very, very well. We'll turn off the bread. And then, we'll add some cheese. some Gruyere or Emmental cheese. Okay, siguro mga 1/4 cup just to add flavor to this sauce mornay. Okay, mix very, very well. Turn it off. This is going to be our sauce. Now, I'm going to show you how to assemble this. Let's taste it muna. Taste. Good. A little more salt. Yan. And you want to add a little more. You have to taste it, you know. If it's okay na, the cheese should give it the proper saltiness. Okay, now, assembly. Okay, so we get the toast bread. Okay. Yan, it's a little bit toasted already. Get some of this mornay sauce. Put it on the bread. Both sides. And spread. Okay. It's not as simple as it looks. There is a very important sauce mornay that goes with it, no? And then what you want to do is get some a good quality ham. You may use any kind of ham. But what I do is I get a good farmer's ham. Okay. Fold it like this. Talagang load it, no? And then you want to get some Dijon mustard. Very, very little Dijon. Dijon kasi has a very strong flavor, no? After that, we're going to put some cheese over the ham. Okay. Ano, sandwich. And then what you want to do is cover it. Okay. Now, that's almost done. What I'm going to do then is get some more of the sauce mornay. Okay. Rub it all over. You know, like I say, no, if you want to remove the sides of the bread, you may do that, no? But personally, that's my favorite part, yung crust. I love the crust. In a baguette, I only eat the crust. So the texture is going to be very different. If you want, you can put some of this mornay sauce also on the side. This is going to be really, really good. So now, I have now a mixture of Emmental or Gruyere cheese. Emmental or Gruyere cheese is the cheese that you use. It's Swiss and French that you use in making onion soup gratiné, di ba? When you eat onion soup, yung parang it's sticky. That's the one. But personally, I find that the Gruyere or Emmental lacks a little bit in flavor. So in strength, no, in terms of taste. So I want to add a little Parmesan cheese to that, okay, and mix it together. And then what I'll do is I'll put this all over this, and now this croque monsieur. Okay. Ang sarap nito. So the cheese is going to bubble and it'll stick because of the presence of the sauce mornay. Okay. And I'm going to bake this. Siguro mga until it melts, and then that's it. I'll show you what this looks like when it comes out. Huh? Show you. Now, this one is done. The cheese has started to bubble. Okay. I'll show you what this looks like. Look at this. It's still bubbling, actually. Yeah. Look at that. And you eat it as is. Now, there's going to be a variety of textures because of the sides, which I didn't remove. But for those of you who want to remove that, normally in a croque monsieur, they suggest you remove that. As is, this is what they call a French croque monsieur, and if you want to make it a croque madame, there are two kinds, a croque monsieur and croque madame. The croque madame, all you have to do is add a fried egg. That becomes a croque madame. Okay? So this one is an authentic French croque monsieur. You have to try this. It's so, so good. Let me round up and tell you what I did today. All these three, I assure you, your family will love. Let me round up and tell you what I did today. I first made an authentic carbonara, but I added a little twist by adding a little garlic. So there's a little aroma of that garlic. And like I said, you may use just egg yolks or just eggs, no? Which I did here. Now, the flavor of this is very, very subtle, but it's so good. So it relies on the quality of your slab bacon. The second recipe is I made a Caesar salad dressing, okay, which I transformed and made a chicken Caesar salad sandwich. So good. Get a good quality bread. Now, I noticed also, because I use extra virgin olive oil, there's a certain smell for or taste of the olive oil. If you don't want that, you may use some healthy oil or just use vegetable oil. Or you can use grapeseed oil and use that so that walang taste ng olives. No? Now, I also have a croque monsieur. All these three, I assure you, your family will love. So, you saw the recipe, you saw the ingredients. Just prepare everything in front of you before you start cooking, and you will have a grand time. You will get praises for all of these. Okay? Try it.